Hello students, today we will be discussing about the JEE mains paper that was conducted in 2017. So here onwards we will be discussing all the 30 questions one by one, the concepts and the tricks to solve the questions of JEE 2017 mains physics paper. Okay. Now students, let us move to the next question. Question number 4. This question says that a time dependent force F equals to 60 acts on a particle of mass 1 kilogram. So there is a time dependent force. If the force is constant, what is given? The force is 60. So as you change t, the force will change. That means at t equals to 0, the force is 0. At t equals to 1, again the force is 6 newton and so on. So that means it is increasing. Okay. Acts on a particle of mass. So this is a particle of mass, say 1 kilogram. So force is acting. If the particle starts from rest, so from rest, time t equals to 0, the particle is at rest. So its initial velocity is 0. The work done by the force during the first 1 second, that means you don't have to spend a lot of time, you have to spend only 1 second. After 1 second, I don't know whatever is the velocity. Suppose I write that the velocity is v here, v at the end of 1 second is this much. Then we have to find the work done by the force during the first 1 second. One thing is that the force is not constant. If the force is not constant, you cannot write work done is F into S. Because which F you are going to write? Because till 1 second, the force is till time t equals 0, when time t equals to 0, the force is 0. So here the force is 0. Here the force is 6 newton. So the force is varying from 0 to 6 newton. The force is not constant. Even if I am finding the displacement, then I cannot write F into S. Because which F I am going to write? So I cannot write like that. Then what I will do? So we will discuss the other method as well. But then first let us solve the question. And then we will discuss if any other method is possible. We are discussing in very detail, unlike other videos, that we will discuss each and everything. We know that for work done and kinetic energy, there is a relation that if I want to find work done, when some confusion is there whether displacement is not given, but if I know the mass and the velocities, initial and final velocities, then during the initial and final velocity, I don't require to know the displacement taking place. I can use the change in kinetic energy formula to find the work done. So we are using work energy theorem that the work done by all the forces, the total work done is change in kinetic energy. Total work done means the work done due to all the forces involved, all the forces that is acting on the object. Maybe gravitational, elastic, electrostatics, or whatever possible cases. Conservative, non-conservative, internal, external, all total work done due to all the forces. But here the only one force is acting, that is 60 force. So the work done by that 60 force is equal to change in kinetic energy, that is final kinetic energy minus initial kinetic energy. okay, that is half m v final square, half m v initial square. This is a change in kinetic energy. If I can find this, then that is the work done. If I take a half m common, then it is v f square minus v I square. M is known 1, so this becomes 1 by 2. Initial velocity is 0, so this is 0. So let me simplify it further. I put the value of m as 1, so it is 1 by 2. And I put the value here 0, so this becomes vf square minus 0 square. So finally, it is vf square divided by 2. This is the work done. But then, what is the final velocity? Unless you find the final velocity, you will not get any of the options. So how to find the final velocity? Okay, that we'll do now. Final velocity is required. Now, looking back to the equation given, F equals to 60. M A, M A I can write, or M dV by dt is 60, that also is possible. M is 1, so I will write M is 1, so it is only dV by dt equals to 60. So dV is 60 dt. I'll integrate both sides of the equation. Time t equals to 0, the velocity is 0. Time t equals to 1, the velocity is required, v final. Okay, so from here, this value, if I solve it, is v final. And this one, 6 comes out, this is t square by 2, so this is t square by 2 or 3, so this is 3t square, 3 times t square, this is 0 to 1, so this is 3. So v final is 3. So final velocity is 3 meter per second. If final velocity is 3 meter per second, then I can put here in this equation that work done is vf square by 2. So I'll write the equation over here that work done is v final square by 2, which is 3 here, so 3 square by 2, which is 9 by 2, which is 4.5 joule. If you see the options, here it is 4.5 joule, so the option 1 is the correct option. Now I was also telling you that if you don't go for integration or to find the velocities, then how to find the velocities? You have to use the equation v is equal to u plus at, but that in that v equals to u plus, or v square is u square plus 2as. There is one equation that we'll also discuss, that there is one equation which is v square minus u square is 2as. This is what we have discussed. You know these equations. Can we use these equations? Initial velocity 0, then can I find final velocity? Or can I use this equation v is equal to u plus at to get a, then you put a here, then get s? This equation is used when a is constant. Remember this. If you think of doing this, then there is a mistake. We have to think, you know, that these equations are straightforward used when the acceleration is constant. But here the acceleration is not constant, the force is 60, the acceleration is changing. So in place of a dt, we have to then write in terms of integration. I cannot write a into t, I have to write some integration method. Okay, so therefore you have to use this to solve the questions. Now, let us move to the next question. Okay.